Hello everyone, how are you today? Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna and this is Irish Donna Darrow. We're going to get started with a Scorpio love reading. We have endless possibilities. This is an opportunity that looks like it could be new for some of you. Broken open. Ooh, there's going to be a breakthrough in love for you, Scorpio. I like it. We also have close encounters. So there is somebody in this relationship who is going through a transformation. The butterflies always tell us that there's a transformation. This person is like a transformation stuck in a cage. So part of the closeness in this relationship that will come about is while someone is healing. But that's kind of normal, you know. We break up with people and we want to have intimacy and love, so we seek love. Scorpio, the overall energy that you come to the reading with is you. Look at you. We have Scorpio energy, Six of Cups, soulmate energy. This energy is someone you may know from the past. It could also feel like someone that you've known a long time. You know, that instant gratification that you get when you meet somebody and you go, wow, I felt so comfortable with them. I felt like I'd known them my whole life. I love this energy, Scorpio, because the loyalty is fierce like you. You know, this is a good representation of your love energy. We see that it looks like it could have been, you know, it can also be someone that you knew a long time ago that you didn't know well, and you're going to have now a fun time of going at, you know, a love relationship. We see manifestation. The Magician card is always all about having all the tools to bring this forward. Right now, I get that you are reluctant to just date one person. It looks like you could be, you know, playing the field a little bit, as we say. Two of coins, you know, making a decision, having two opportunities, juggling your options. So Scorpio, this is your person's energy coming into the reading. It is their thoughts about where they're at, how they, what they can bring to the table. Your person is very optimistic. They're very optimistic that this relationship could be a very special relationship in which there would be a lot of happiness, joy, and love. They feel lucky to have met you. When we get the Three of Coins as a card of collaboration, they feel as though you could, you know, you would work well together as a couple. You know, hey, what do you want to do this Saturday? Gee, I'd like to go to a movie. Gee, that sounds wonderful. I would too. So it's really a very mutually supportive, benefic energy for you. Six of Coins is always about equal give and take. Both people really bringing their best game to the table. We also see that your person is all up in their head, Gemini energy, they're worried, but we have Capricorn, we have Taurus, and we have Virgo energy. So there's a lot of practicality that this person, a lot of groundedness that this person is coming in, and that's what they think of you. They think of you as a person with whom they could safely, with the Wheel of Fortune, lucky, Jupiter, good luck, you know, expansion. They also feel with this Scorpio energy, this is the card, the number 22 in the tarot deck does not exist in any other deck that I own. This is the only one. It's the Naked Heart Tarot. You can see that this is, it's a twin flame, 11-11, Scorpio energy right there. So your person feels as though they feel this very, almost shocking, interest in you, like how could I feel this much this quickly? We look at their heart space, they're very hesitant to open up, and that's because they feel that they've been through a lot. When we look at this little character here, what we see is like a cartoon character. You know, have you ever watched cartoons and, you know, the violence is portrayed by a punch to the head and then the person sort of is dizzy and they go cuckoo cuckoo, they look like they're gonna fall over. So I get this person is really still a bit affected, not badly so, but affected by a relationship that they walked away from. Virgo energy, after a lot of soul searching, they are in their heart space, they're coming in as a person who's very open to love. That's a Scorpio King. So you may be dealing with another Scorpio Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus, but maybe not. It's an energy. In their heart space, they feel that you have a wonderful open heart with mastery over your emotions. They feel that, you know, they won't have to walk away because they will receive a quality love relationship with you. This person's very practical. We see two cards of Virgo here. And we see your person has closed out a cycle of disappointment and endings. So their heart isn't quite ready yet for love. And that's what I think is going to be, you know, endless possibilities as they open up. But remember, this is a portrayal of somebody who has their heart locked away for a short time, but not badly. They really are praying that it gets broken open. They don't want to stay in this energy of feeling, you know, closed off. This is not abnormal or unusual for a new beginning in a relationship. For those of you who are coming back together again after a long period of time, I still see this disharmony here in terms of their heart space, wanting to be very much in love with you, searching for answers of how to open themselves up again. I feel it's very favorable. You know, I think it's normal behavior with a healthy person who is really looking to do the right thing and be in the right place in the right relationship. The energy of their intentions. Well, they want to heal themselves. The Justice card indicates that they could have just left another relationship or another legal commitment. It is the seventh house of marriage. Typically, the Justice card, though, also shows me that they intend to throw caution to the winds. They're not telling you right now, but once they recognize that you will not stab them in the back, you know, they're going to be a little defensive with you until they realize that the worst is over. This is in the past. You know, they know it intellectually, but they don't know it. I always say getting information from your head to your heart can take time. So that's the transition that I see taking place, the transformation. Your person is healing. They're healing very nicely. They're also very sweet. You know, your person is very kind, very loving, very discreet. They have a tendency not to speak bluntly. This is Cancerian energy or Pisces energy, but it's all very watery, nurturing, soft, sweet, kind energy. They wouldn't even know how to do things otherwise, so it's funny to say that they intend to be nice. They just are nice. The Ten of Swords is a card that we will clarify in terms of what's happening with that. We'll clarify the more difficult cards here for you before we leave the reading, of course. We see their actions. Scorpio, here you are, Scorpio King twice. So your person has mastery over their emotions, as do you. Right now, for the next, I would say, 5 weeks, period of five, can be 5 months, but I think it's probably been 5 months since they left another relationship. So they are still struggling in their heart space, but they're being very quiet. They recognize that they're healing. When we get the Page of Pentacles, we've gotten the Page of Pentacles twice. So they're going to make a very nice offer to you about what they can give you in love. The Star card is healing, but it's also Aquarius energy. It's the ascension. It's, you know, we get the Star card. I call it the rock star card because it's like spiritual rock star, spiritual warrior. This person has been through the mill. They are an incredibly enlightened person, and we see the energy for you, Scorpio, that this is wish fulfillment in love. The Star card means hopes and dreams for love coming true, or hopes and dreams for anything that you love or desire coming true. We see that your person is very much in the energy Spirit of Swords. They're staying very cool, calm, intellectual, aloof. And that's not the greatest energy, but I think that they will balance it out with the Scorpio King energy, which is very passionate, very hot, very intense, but certainly very well contained in an appropriate and very honorable manner. The Three of Swords says that it does look like they were betrayed by someone, gave them the knockout punch to the head. It has them all in their head now, but they are doing a beautiful job of healing. So let's look, Scorpio, and see what these clarifiers are for the Nine of Swords at the top. Why are they all up in their head? Why are they all up in their head with this Gemini energy? Why do they? Now, you may work with this person. There's so many coins here in the top row that you could have met them at work. It could also be like going back for a class reunion or being, you know, you could be somewhere else. You could have been traveling to your hometown and run into them at the dime store or something. All right. So it does look like your person wants marriage, but they're afraid of marriage. It does look like they've left a marriage or a significant relationship that was marriage-like. I like that. Ten of Coins is, this is a person who wants to build a legacy with you till death do us part. Very profound energy. Spirit of Pentacles, we are seeing the energy of reliability. Your person, even though they've gone through a lot, your person is in the energy of the King of Pentacles, Taurus energy. That is your seventh house of marriage, and it shows us that your person's very reliable, very steadfast in their love. And the Eight of Cups, why is this walking away energy here? Temperance. Okay, so what this means is that for some of you, you could have had a breakup with this person. They might have gone off and had another relationship. I can see this happening a lot of different ways. One storyline would be that, you know, you went to school with them and you both went your separate ways and you lived part of life and now you're coming into alignment again. For others, and this will, I don't think this is highly likely at all, but for some of you, this could be a person that walked away and betrayed you, but I am not reading it that way. That would be like one person out there is what I'm seeing. But let me know in the comments. And I also love to know where you're watching the video from around the world. Please leave a comment and also tell me your feedback. The Eight of Swords is clarifying the Virgo Hermit card. So the Eight of Swords says that they're not going to rush in and do much. They still have their heart in the cage, okay? So it's okay, though, because they do have the intention, when we look at their thoughts here, that they're going to take it slowly, and they're not going to rush anything. The Six of Swords is here. Why? The Death card. So they are moving away from an ending. It does look almost positively like it was a marriage in which there was a betrayal. All right, so let's see why we have the Ten of Swords here. We have Four of Cups. Your person is worried that you might not be willing to take the leap of faith with them. They are willing to take the leap of faith with you, but they don't know if you're going to accept their cup of love. The Heart of Wands, though, they find you very sexy. They intend to pursue this relationship. In terms of their actions, the Five of Cups is they're feeling a little down and cloudy and gloomy, but they do want new love. So they have been feeling unloved and unlovable a bit, but they're coming into this energy with wanting a new beginning in love. We have the Page of Pentacles. They want to get to know you, get to know all about you, learn what you like, learn how to please you in every way, Scorpio, and you know what I mean. We see the Three of Swords here. Oh, I hate that heartbreak card, but your person has a really good handle on it. Intellectually, they really understand what is going on here, and part of what they didn't receive in their relationship was equal give and take. Let's see what else. We have the Hermit card. They were left alone a lot. Your person was ghosted or abandoned in that relationship for someone else. The Nine of Cups, though, they're pretty happy-go-lucky by nature as a human being. So, Scorpio, that's your reading right now. I hope you enjoyed it. Please let me know what you think in the comments below. Thank you so much for joining me. Sending you love from Chicago. Send some back and tell me where you're from. Thank you. Bye-bye.